the Hulk is engaged in conversation with Doctor Strange on the astral plane, while U.S. forces under the command of General Thunderbolt Ross rip his body to shreds with adamantium shards, his skin hardly standing up to 10 tons of the unbreakable metal due to Bruce being distracted by Stefan, proving once again that the Hulk's durability and invulnerability are connected to his willpower and mind. Of course, that was the plan all along, to talk him into stopping his attack on New York while being pounded heavily by the military, which allowed Strange entrance into Bruce's mind. In the end, Bruce breaks the Sorcerer Supreme's hands while, inside the astral plane, escapes back into the real world and gives Ross a taste of his own medicine, destroying his tanks and attack choppers like a child playing with mere toys. Meanwhile, Doctor Strange suffers real-world injuries, Hulk having crushed his hands seemingly beyond repair. And that's the Hulk, folks. Possessing an invulnerability controlled and manipulated by his very whims. If he wishes it, he can be immovable, indestructible. He can make his molecular structure truly dense, or weaken it, allowing someone like Speed Freak or Wolverine to cut his skin without effort. Yes, this is true, and these are facts. Remember that Bruce Banner isn't really mentally stable, and he himself isn't like Thor, a being who thrives on the energy of war and violence, but Hulk would much rather stay away from people. He'd rather keep out of reach, not willing to endanger innocence. A part of his invulnerability is his adapting to inhospitable environments whenever it becomes necessary. There were many occasions where Hulk not only survived airless space or breathed underwater, but has also spoken in it. Same as his healing factor. The angrier or more emotional the Hulk gets, the faster he adapts. His physiology allows him to survive indefinitely without food, water, air, or sleep after he has adapted. In many of his fights, he has proven his nigh-unlimited invulnerability, matching impregnable giants like the Juggernaut, skin for skin, if you will, or just withstanding and defeating the physics-bending powers of magic. So here goes. I'm not going to give you 15 different scenes in where the Hulk stops a planet with his chest or absorbs the sun into his belly button. No, I've already done that in the other videos. We already know he's withstood blows from Thor and his lightning, punches from Superman and Gladiator's heat vision beams, absorbed magic and mental attacks. This can be found anywhere. What I'm going to do is show you guys what convinced me of Hulk's incredible durability and nigh invulnerability. Yes, it's in the pages of bullet point number 5. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Hulk versus Galactus. It was absurd. One pathetic creature, reviled and feared, even among his own kind, standing alone where others had fallen. Absurd. Pathetic. Not even worth the barest touch of the power cosmic, when the power of Galactus alone could shatter mountains. Absurd. Pathetic. Inevitable. Inevitable. Absurd. Pathetic. Inevitable. It was an impossibility, an indignity. Any other creature would have fallen and had to fall. Even without calling upon the power cosmic, this was the fire. This was the power that was Galactus. This creature would yield, The creature refused. And Galactus,
who had devoured thousands of worlds without care or emotion, without regard or involvement, for the first time, knew rage. And Norrin Rad, who had left behind that name to become the Silver Surfer, who had served at the pleasure of his master for years without count, hesitated. With the power cosmic burning in his veins, the Norrin within the Surfer knew that this distorted, reviled creature was not battling to save its own life. It was not fighting to save the world. It cared nothing for the sake of the world. Many will risk their lives for glory, for fame, to save the world or themselves. What kind of creature would lay down his life before a world that feared and hated it? To save just one person?